Hey guys, it's Christy and welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me. Today, we're gonna be revisiting my 2020 favorites, so the products that I chose at the end of last year as my number one favorite in each category. So before we get into it, I hope you'll consider subscribing to my channel before you leave. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy, and let's get into it. Okay, so I didn't actually do a ranking of every single category last year. I just ranked essentially the categories where I had a lot to say. So I don't actually have anything for brows. I don't think I picked any lip products last year either. It was 2020. But let's just get into it. So the first thing I see on my list was my very favorite face palette was from Jouer. This was the Champagne and Macarons face palette. I believe this is actually on sale at Sephora right now for half price. This is still a favorite. It's not my very favorite in my collection anymore. It has been dethroned, sadly, but I still really, really love this. This is still in my top three, I would say. The highlight Citrine is just so stunning. The matte blush in Romance Me is also gorgeous. Delight Me is more of a shimmery blush. That one took some time to wear on me, but it definitely did. I have a really healthy dent in the Suntan bronzer, so I really still love this. I really, really do. There's no regrets on this palette. This was a great, great purchase. I just found some things this year that I preferred a little more. However, this is absolutely stunning. All right, so the next product I don't actually have anymore because I finished, and that is the L'Oreal Infallible 24-Hour Fresh Wear Foundation. That was a favorite of mine for such a long time. I loved that foundation. It did get dethroned this year. It did. I won't tell you what the new favorite is because that's coming up in another video, but it's definitely been dethroned. It is still a favorite. It's still probably sitting around number two or three on my list of favorite foundations, but overall this year I did find one that I like more. All right, last year my favorite concealer overall was the Milani Conceal and Perfect. So this has been around for an age. This is a beautiful drugstore concealer. It does a really great job covering everything up, blending out. It is pretty full coverage. It's a beautiful, beautiful concealer. Has been dethroned twice now. There have been two concealers this year that I have tried that I prefer to this one. One of them, if you have seen my videos, you know is going to be the One Size Concealer. And I can tell you that because there's a couple others that you may not know about yet. The One Size Concealer for sure has dethroned this, and I will let you know in an upcoming video the other two, but this is still a beautiful, beautiful drugstore option. It's just not number one anymore. All right. My favorite blush last year was the Fenty Cream Blush in Petal Poppin'. So it's weird that I had a cream blush as a favorite, but I just really, really like this one. I am somebody who just defaults to powders. It's just my preference, but this one is just so pretty. There's something with the shade, the way it blends. It's just so beautiful. I've really, really enjoyed this one. I would say it's been dethroned. It's definitely not my favorite. I haven't reached for it a lot this year, but I still think it's a beautiful option. When I want a cream blush, I do tend to grab for this one, but I've definitely chosen some new favorites this year as well. For highlighter, last year I had the Revlon Skin Lights highlighter as a favorite, and it is still going very strong. It is still a favorite of mine. I guess you could say it's been dethroned. The Charlotte Tilbury highlight that's in her Instant Look of Love in a Palette and her Filmstar Bronze and Glow, it's the same highlighter. That one is gotta be my all-time favorite highlighter formula, but this is still a close second. I really, really do love this. I love everything about this highlighter. It is definitely more blingy than I typically prefer, but I just think it's so pretty. I love the formula. It's drugstore. It's so good. It's gonna last me forever because who uses this much highlighter, but it's gorgeous. So this one, as a single individual product, is still my favorite highlighter, but if we're unfortunately comparing it to all highlighters in general, it is now at number two. For bronzer, bronzer is a funny category for me because I haven't always been somebody who wears a ton of bronzer. And I would say within the past year, I've really started to have a love for bronzer. Last year, my favorite was the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. I know, it's a lot of people's favorite. That's not new. I have tried a lot of new bronzers this year, a lot that I really enjoy. I'll talk about those in an upcoming video, but I would still say this is my all-time favorite. It could be the tone, could be the scent. I don't know what it is. I just love the way it goes on. It takes like no work to blend. It looks so pretty and kind of natural, to be honest. I really, really just love this bronzer the most. And so this is the one from last year that has absolutely held strong for me. I love this so much and it still smells really good. The only complaint about this one is the packaging because the lids always seem to break on these, but it's still a favorite. All right, last year my favorite mascara was the Marc Jacobs At Lashed Mascara, and that is a good one, but it's definitely been dethroned. Again, I have a video coming up on my favorite mascaras of the year. But yeah, it's no longer a favorite. It was very beautiful. I would recommend it. I think it's a great option. If I received one, I would not be upset. It's just not the number one tier anymore. So that has also been dethroned. I've tried a lot of really great makeup this year. A lot. Okay, and finally, my favorite eyeshadow palette of 2020 was from Natasha Denona, and that was the Glam palette. So this is still a beautiful, beautiful option. This is still one I reach for all the time that I really enjoy. It's definitely among the favorites in my collection, but I don't think it's number one anymore. I do love this. I think it's absolutely stunning. It's such a great option for every day, and I do still have a deep love for it, which tells me that it was a strong purchase last year. But again, I've just tried some amazing, amazing products this year, so that's why I can't place it at number one. But that is it. So it looks like a lot of my favorites from last year have been dethroned as my all-time favorite products. That's okay, that happens. That just means we had a great year of makeup. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. This was a kind of a fun little one to revisit. I'm excited to see that I still play with my last year's favorites all the time, even though maybe they're not in that top spot anymore. I still play with them all the time. I still love them very much. So I still had good taste. I still had good taste last year. I just found a lot more this year. So that is it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you'll consider subscribing before you go. I do upload at least 3 new videos every single week. And that is it for me today. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.